薄清法主讲者五进妙义
Mr. Brown William McCarthy Index
目录
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Dao
第一章为什么他们恭喜我有得到
Chapter 2 What is Dao
二章当蛇模式到
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures?
第三章何谓三宝
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor make an oath at the altar?
第四章为什么引宝要立愿
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Dao
第五章为什么要力求道愿
Chapter 6 How to save human beings
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Dao is an omen I would extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious dayToday you have received the Dao which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the Dao and by transcending the limitations of birth and death have become immortal. That which you have received today is the same Dao. Formerly,One who intended to receive the Dao had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to resign his high position. His family and to the road mountains to seek a master who would transmit the Dao to him.After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send beatitudes metta out to him. Under such conditions a penable to succeed was hard to find.During that period the Dao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天宝各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子今天你们得了道道是至宝道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道故他们能超出生死之限而永存。今天你们所得的道一同他们其实所得道一样。在古时人要得到必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位帝也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大他必须舍弃他的爵位离开家人入深山寻访能够指点他途径。传授大道给他的名师在他经历千辛万苦之后同时已将凡心修成佛心并以达至圆满之行为已做了许善事加志之下终于感动天之心派仙佛来指点传授大道给他在如此之情况下成功者非常稀少在那时道是由祖师你给下一代祖师
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselves. We may find the means to do so in our own environment. Therefore must take full advantage of our fortunate circumstances. Pause are in close proximity to the Tao. Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race. What is the cause of these calamities? In this modern age, most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve the human problem. Would seem as the conscience or soul are only religious terms and have no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters the likes of which had never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the gods in heaven will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们亦莫修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到？这是因为时代不同。现在人类灭绝之灵，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们共盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出自然，科学是高于一切，科是能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真，这里是我良道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万古长存。它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生，大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫，我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、普的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, GodOf whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikung and Bodhidharma.To rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikung and Bodhisattva, you are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting out to the three kinds of beings.Their duty is to manage the work called the Last Salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out original maker console of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
是我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝，是非常的慈悲，一不忍善恶俱焚，因此降下真道顶派灵师济公活佛与月慧胡萨降世，挽救三曹替天之大仙，世界的众生，地府的鬼魂返堂。 我们师尊师母二位老人老的命令，真传真守，普渡三宝们的责任是办理幕后一员事，立文字，教外别传，直至人心，直至人人固有之良心。
When the last Valandi arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way, which is the Tao sent from God. That is why the Tao is widely propagated to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore, after we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be saved from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以救众生，除了上帝所降下的义之道。因此，现在大道普渡善男信女。古人是先修后的，先修道然后才得道。现在我们是先的后修。 因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫比难超了。成佛。Although
it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background. Today you receive the Tao because you have an affinity with our temple and you and your ancestors have performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous life. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity, you would never receive it.
虽然人以古更得好，然而亦是各凭各知根基缘分。今天你们得道皆因与佛有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德。 也许前世有修过五大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有缘得道，则将不能到。Chapter
2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen? You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God's power. Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the devil will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled, and beyond or of human comprehension. Tao activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God SS. We are God as children.
各位今天已经得到，就近的是什么？什么是道？道是天地人万物之母，道是宇宙之本源，创造者以及主宰者。道上帝，道至尊至贵之神。当天地还未生之前，一切都未有之前。 道一天存在的，当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭，道能再生天地人万物，天以人万物生成了道其宗主宰，道非常奥妙，道无形无相，视而不见，听而不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。 道超出了人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作，道是无为而为的，即莫是所依。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在。 因为一切都依靠道而的魂，上帝，我们之灵是上帝所赐，我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law. When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it our conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother. In Chinese, she is Lao Mu. All I left the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言， 称它为道，在它作为一只主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，使我们生存并支配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老。 这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now, what you actually received is the Tao. The everybody as yourself. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened. Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们得的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们已的名师是解开了灵性，现在你认了体非真正的你，而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。然而在支配你的身体的灵性， 才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already have you yet not realize it. Therefore,You have had to search for it and had now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures.This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You bounce. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you.You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时，灵性在他体内。若灵性已离开他，立刻就死亡。灵性天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上我们已有在身上，为何还要再寻求他？还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识他了。我们以为肉体真我而不知它原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了持此色身，享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性。而我们已不是仅限于此肉身，我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰。因灵性老师的性满了悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasure.The heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heaven portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible.2. The portal of birth and death, the high portal door, which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven is specific.Heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of Tao, heaven's very far away, but with real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经？天，你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝：一玄、观二口、玄三合同。一第一宝，玄观，玄观玄妙莫测之门。 玄关点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心，它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点此之门玄是领出身体之门户，孔子曰：谁能出不由？ 和莫由斯道也三点通天大路佛经云：西天十万八千里，此事譬喻亦成佛事不易之事，因为名难法大道还不传。然而明师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。
The main entrance, the heavenly portal, is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher, your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. It will have to leave by one of the side gates. A. The eyes, be the ears, see. Mouth, be the nose, even navel. F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. The eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. Mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as fish, lobster, etc. The nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee, etc. The navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. A vertex, it is reborn as a man pup.
Person。正门关正门，正位于中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我明。 当无门的出现，只能其旁门出去，眼口鼻其隐门。如果灵性走旁门一游而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类；二由眼而出者，来生 当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类；三由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类；四由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如蝇、蜜蜂之类；五由肚脐而出者，生为皮中之 人。六由隐门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。 上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路。我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回兽。但是我们必须要修，否则玄关虽开， 我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。5:5
In the Bible, Matthew 14 of John, to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transferred to you in the temple of God through God's action and commandment. The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to a lead liner from the holy lamp. Then, using his finger, connect God's spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one, thereby enlightening you with God's spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载约翰对他的门徒说：“我用水给你们施洗，表明你们悔改。然而爱我，后的将用灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命。” 那盏佛灯代表上帝老，在点到之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以相助从佛灯引来一条经指向你们的玄关，然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时， 上帝一一的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。6:5
You need to said I had the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal.
6. 释迦牟尼佛云有这法眼藏词语暗示玄关之彼。Be
the second treasure, the divine mantra 1. You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves. It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself, you will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
2:5 宝口诀心经或五字真经，一刚才传授口诀给你们，还记得吗？请再说一遍。当性命危险时，你才用此宝，将真经默念口中，受报而同。你。 你将科被仙佛救护，脱离危险。 不过要注意此口诀仅能于性命为及支持方可运用。假若我们真诚修道，当然我们将受天佛之庇佑。二点
The divine entrance connects your true self with God. This mantra is without form, sound or color and is the essence of all, the underlying and ultimate principle of the universe. This mantra unites your being with that of the Tao, forming a powerful bond. Every great religion indicates this potential unity, but they do not fully understand how to implement and effect it. You now have this knowledge and are familiar with its application.
二心经，环受有生音达无音，我知心由千经万典而达入真经真典，心经心法真空也，真我本性也。三点
The true teaching is transmitted from mind to mind. The self, the I, the spirit, the mind will indicate the center and is real.Real essence and original indestructible nature which is identical with Tao. The human being is a microcosm, sharing all the attributes of the macrocosm. Since he is essentially divine, man only needs to understand nature, reality and align himself with it. The more pure and refined his nature,the more conscious he becomes of his relationship with the Tao. He realizes that he is one with Tao. He has become fully enlightened.
三以心传心口传心手以老之心传于众生之真心此者老的分灵之心也
See.The third treasure, the symbolic seal one. In Chinese, Ha means to combine and to knit all together. The symbolic seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which is formed by the two hands joined together as the golden seal which unites us with God.It is like a contract or a mutual agreement which is the actual meaning of Hatun between and your heavenly mother. It acts as a signal, password, or passport. It is a spiritual instrument of identification, as well as symbol with many ramifications. 2.When you hold symbolic seal you are united with God. 3. The left hand is good so it is placed on the outside, covering the right hand. The right hand is often used for evil purposes, such as beating and killing. The right hand is placed in the inside causes evil propensities and yielding.The left hand. Together the hands hold the word child which is formed by the two thumbs in proximity symbolizing the Chinese word hai which means child. This hand symbol acts as directional to God. It serves to mobilize heavenly protection and causes the user to escape from any impending calamity.4. Let's quote some words from Bible Matthew 19:13-15. Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on and to pray for them, but the disciples scolded the people. Jesus said, Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of heaven belongs to them. He placed his hands on them and then went away. This illustrates the power and significance of the solid seal. At that time Jesus placed his hands on the children's heads and explained that this is a to ask him. Today hold child and realize that we are the children of God and are willing to return to God's presence.
三第三抱和同一点和同之意和是合成一体。同是相同，和同象征似我们经，要是自我也不跟我们手抱和同，表示我们要与老合成一体，同老一样，是说与老和灵永不再分开。二点和和同，同同和，抱起和同。能闭眼罗三点左手属善当在外右手属恶居内边子亥相掐怀中抱能脱酒大大节观四现在让我们应用圣经之语句有一些人带孩子们到耶稣跟前求耶稣为他们按手祝福但是使徒则那些人耶稣说让孩子们到我这里来不要阻止他们因为上帝的国是属于如此的人耶稣为他们按手祝福然后离开从这件事我们可以了解他是对和同之一种预言在那时耶稣把手按在孩子头上并说须如此方能返回天国。如今我们手抱子海觉并觉悟我们是上帝的儿女且一回返上一身。
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar before you receive the vow from your teacher? Two persons take an oath at the altar, one as your introducer and one as your sponsor. Without these two persons, the vow will not be transmitted to you. The introducer vouches for your character and guarantees your good conduct. The sponsor guarantees that vow is true and the teachings are genuine. A vow is also taken to guarantee that any money which you may donate to the temple will only be used for the printing of books and other such noble purposes.
第四章为什么银宝要立愿在点师来为钱道给你之前有两个人做你的银宝师先立愿银宝你求道否则点传师不可传道给你证人保证你是好人并发誓门是引你入正道并非左道旁门或邪教他们并非狂哄你的钱财否则他们愿受天雷诛你奉献的功德经是来演佛堂引善书任何人也能他用在私人用途上
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao. Before anyone receives the Tao, he has to take a vow which states that he will faithfully adhere to the principles of Tao and will not reveal the Si teachings of the teachers to anybody.
第五章，为什么要力求告愿？每个人在为求告前，必须先立愿，表白他将诚心报告及不泄露天机三宝给任何人。
Chapter 6 How to Save Mandis. Now has Eve a vow which ineffable, sacred and sublime. You have just been saved by someone, so now you should try your best to spread these exalted teachings to your fellow human beings and urge your family, friends and acquaintances to receive the vow. This is of great merit for you because you are not only saved someone's physical body from disaster, but you are also saving his true self from the sufferings of incarnation. All you not only save that one person because, if he cultivates himself properly,He can also save seven generations of his offspring by his virtue. How great is your merit!
第六章，如何救度众生？如今你已得了大道至宝，你已被救，你应该去救度别人，所以你尽量的度你家人亲戚朋友求道，让他们亦得蒙上天之恩典，此乃你莫大之功德。因为你不仅救了他的灵性脱离轮回之苦，并且救他色脱离劫难，同时你不仅是救了一人，假若他真修，他将能以他的功德来超拔九玄七祖，你的功德何其大呀！
And you're already using the ao.html
先天大道简介中英对照
http://www.cloudberry.com/category6/63006.htm Introduction to the AO
先天大道简介
Introduction to the AO
中英对照先天大道简介以何为先天大道二道与我有什么关系三求道是求什么四求道对我有什么好处五具备什么条件才可以求道六求道对我的生活有什么影响七道的宝贵有什么印证以何为先天大道先天大道又简称道我们若仔细地去观察，心窍开悟之后，就可发觉宇宙间森罗万些是杂而有趣，而自然界万事万物的运转，也都有一定的法则。各天地人是万物的真主宰，就是道。道乃在天地生成之前即已存在，故曰先天大道。这理，理就是真理。在天地人、万物未生以前，道即已存在，而道能生天、生地、生人、生万物万类。在天地人、万物毁灭之后。道不会毁灭，道因为无去无来，不增不减，乃代表着宇宙间亘古不变的真理。道的本体，也就是宇宙自然的本体，在混沌未判之初，宇宙间只是环灵妙理，无天无地无人，也。没有语言和文字，所以本时话已 和言管字思虑来形容他。故大道无名强名曰道，我们也是勉强用到这个名词来代表他。在天地万物生成之后，早就能贯穿于宇宙万事万物之中，使一切自然现均能现协调问的转。这就是道的妙用。道大理为，我们虽然无时无刻离不开道的本体和妙用，却又很不易去认识它。应在三年前，各教圣人应运出世，各化一方，针对当时天时地利及众生的根气，留下千经万典，传下诸多去恶从善的修持法门，同时也让芸芸众生认识明明宇宙万物均有一个真正的主宰，或称为上帝，或称为造化，或称为天主，我们称其为或生老是明而同意。我们对道有了深一层的认识和体悟之后，就会了解天地间实无一物不是之本体与道用合一。因此道虽然涵盖各大教门的经义，为千门万教的总源头，确实不局限于宗教的领域里，而是或也不只代表着一切宗教的最高信仰中心，更是天地万事万物万类的根本源头与最高主宰，及宇宙间永恒不变的真理智。所以今天有机会了解吗？是先天大道，不只找到了各大教门的最高信仰中心，也找到了宇宙的根本源头与最高主宰，更能对宇宙高上的真理有一个初步的认识。道之真理，在先天之先不为先，在后天之后不为后，即上有可量，即为上有可为道，即大不可量，即为不可止。不所以大，无不包围，无不入，无所不贯，无所不通，无所不彻，贯彻了天地人万物万类，贯彻了33天，贯彻了天经万典，贯彻了天法万法，贯彻了天教万教，贯彻了天佛万祖，贯彻了我之一身浅大宝贵真意。人人必须知真觉，亦即是人人与我，我与人人良心之行也。此乃万众一心，万国一家，世界大同，此先天大道之宝贵也。二，道与我有什么关系？道的宝贵在于它大而无所不包，细而无所不入。天地生成之后，贯穿于天地万物万类，使得日月星辰之运转各有其时，四时之交替，万物之消长各有其序。而最宝贵的是各天地万物的主宰，同时也是我们一生之主宰，曰性理，是得我们 不学而能看，能听，能吃，能懂。因此，我们不只要探求天地间的治理，更要回头是问身上不有的真理。不偏偏大道即是性理真传，道的宝贵并不在于它有什么神秘有特殊之处，而是与它平时，但我们却时时刻刻离不开它的本体与妙用。我们反观一下自身，就会发觉我们身体的结构是非常精密和奥妙的。我们轻轻地握一下手，就算是这么简单的一个动作，其中所牵涉到的所有关节物理作用、能量、化学反应、经统资料、讯息传输、肌脑分析、断命令之下达，以目前全世界的科技知识和文明水准，也无法一一表达出来。但是我们做出个动作的能力，却完全不因个人知道上了程度的差异而有任何影响。不论是学识多丰富的学者，或是目不识丁贩夫走卒，不论是成人或是刚生有的婴儿，都可以轻而易举地做出的动作。人人与生俱来，不学而知，不学而能，无增无减的良知良能，就是主宰我们意识的道。我们有学习而得到的知识和才能，有忘记的时候，有疏远的时候，而道的本体和妙用，不用学习，不用思考，大而能来宇宙的运作消长，小而能主宰我意识知识听一动。我们有而不知其有，用而不知其用，却又无时无刻不能缺少它。的不增不减，本自具足一切我们身上固有的道，因为就在我们身上，又称作自性老。我们了解了个主宰天地万物的道，在我们身上有它的作用，不应受到我们赞美或否认而有任何增减。不论种族、肤色、国籍、宗教、信仰或贫贱富贵，均无分无别。因我们能求得先天大道，不止到了宙的本源头，也找到了不灭的真我。不只认识了宇宙，也认识了我一生的真正主宰。不只追求到了宇宙之治理，也找回了我身上本有的真理与良知良能。先天大道的根源是在我身上，原来固有的是我由先天带来的良知良能，即是我的良心。我的良心即是天心，天心即是心，此心无形无相，即是真空。真空之一妙，空而不空，空中妙有，妙有者天当地人，万物万之大本也。妙用者，万灵真宰也，主宰天地人，万物万类之真主宰，亦即是主宰我之一身。故曰道在无身，一切万能。 道理无深此深百无能天道此宝贵百人人必须求道三求道是求什么静心观察我们所存在的这宇宙我们往往会赞造物主的神奇自然界每一刻皆有无数的事物在同时运转其整理却是那些我们身体的这个真理不也是一样吗每一分一秒我们身上皆有无数的生化反应物理作用等同时发生道的妙用分布在我们身上不用学习不用思考其纵成千上万合起来来却只有一个自我一切有条不紊自然而成道在无声运用如在眼是在耳能听在口能言在口闻臭在身能运用情动作事此即道在我身之妙用所以我们了解了道不止主宰着天地万物更主宰我们一生宇宙根本源头最高主宰于我一生主宰并二道的体无形无相我们肉眼看不到它手也摸不到它但它却无时无刻不再发挥其妙用更进而随着天时及环境而发展出语言文字经典及造福人类的文明此即是我们良知良能之作用一般人不了解到在于我们自身的本体和妙用只模糊意识到它的存在便以灵魂代表它我们称其为自性因且有灭也不毁坏我也称其为真我此真我乃是最富足最圆满最光明最完美永恒不朽的现在我们来生一看看的摸的有形有相的肉体能不能代表我一个人生命中不同阶段的照片拿来比较我们就可发觉面貌是无时无刻不在变的我们一般均习惯样貌肉人但相貌却不是永恒的我们肢体也不是真我某些人不幸失去了一只手或一只脚仍是好好活着我们的内脏呢现在科学昌明其至己能把动物的心脏成功地植入人体我们不能因此说的人不是他自己了就算熬得起从我们一出生就是的在坏死减少和变化之因此有形有相的肉体只是真我的一个工具而已肉体虽然看似真实